The Tesla Bobcat Project. What is it? Bobcat, Tesla's new project, but what is it about? It is going to be about batteries, or maybe electric cars, or maybe this time, Tesla is planning something different. Earlier, Tesla had bought new land next to its Gigafactory, Texas. This 150.21 acres of land is up for Bobcat Project, but this project is yet to be revealed. Hello and welcome back to TechSphere, guys. In today's video, we are going to tell you about the big cat that Tesla will soon be revealing. But for now, all we have is information of what is going on. So stay with us until the end of the video. Tesla has purchased additional land to the east of the Giga Texas project that is currently being built. Tesla purchased another piece of land, according to documents from the Austin, Texas public database. But what are the company's plans for it? Here's what we've learned so far. Tesla has purchased another block of land measuring 150.21 acres and 6,543,147.6 square feet, according to the paperwork from the Austin, Texas public database. It was bought by the Colorado River Project, Tesla's Texas affiliate, which also bought the site for what became known as the Giga Texas Project, under the same name. Since Tesla has acquired so much land around the Gigafactory Texas project, it's unclear where the facility will be built. The new facility, according to the records, can cover up to 97 acres, but it is still not confirmed what it would be used for. According to sources, the land is located exactly to the east of the main Giga Texas location, making it nearly directly connected to Tesla's primary vehicle production facility. Tesla has submitted site plans and an environmental review, according to the papers, but several other documents are still pending. There are currently no plans in place, and Tesla has given no indication of what the facility might be utilized for. What's more? Well, there's a lot of speculation about what's going on. Business Journal Austin mentioned in its report that outside of Austin, Tesla's Colorado River Project LLC has already purchased almost 2,500 acres. Tesla has been doing repair work since last year, according to Andy Lenzinsian, assistant director of Austin's Development Service Department. This was done to keep its mining operation on the land to a minimum. It further stated, documents recently filed with the city of Austin indicate Tesla Incorporated plans another facility on its land in eastern Travis County. There aren't too many details about what the facility would be used for, and project representatives either declined to comment or could not be reached by publication time. But a site plan filed April 30th for Tesla's Bobcat project points to another industrial building rising off Harold Green Road near the company's $1.1 billion Gigafactory. However, according to rumors circulating in the Tesla community, a battery cell manufacturing plant is at work. It makes sense given that the company is committed to developing its own 4680 cells. The 4680 cells, which are now being manufactured at Tesla's Cato Road facility in Northern California, were presented by Tesla last September at the company's Battery Day event. Project Tiger was the code name for the Gigafactory Nevada plant in Sparks, Nevada. And it's worth noting that Tesla has previously utilized cat-themed code names for battery projects. The Tesla Gigafactory is a factory that produces electric motors and battery packs for the Model 3. The plant also produces Tesla's Powerwall and PowerPack energy products. But many people have been asking recently, what inspired Tesla to choose the name of cats for its projects? Lion, a common abbreviation for lithium-ion battery cells, which are used in electric vehicles, may have inspired Tesla's plan to utilize a cat. Tesla's Project Tiger, which resulted in the Gigafactory in Sparks, Nevada, may have been inspired by Lion or Lion. As far as the site is concerned, the development on the new facility has already begun, and drone footage of the building site has been revealed by TerraFactory Texas on YouTube. The footage reveals that site preparation is already underway to the east of the plant. For the time being, a part of the land has been covered in preparation for building, while another half still has a pond. It's worth noting that this portion was designed for the construction of a road rather than a building, with plans to track the development. Tesla is the market leader in electric vehicles, and with well over 1 million vehicles on the road today, it's no wonder that supply is struggling to keep up with demand. The automaker is growing day by day, with factories in the United States, China, and Germany, so in the near future, Tesla expects to see a shortage of batteries as soon as 2022, a year in which estimates production to be around 100 gigawatt hours. Rather than terminating all collaborations with current partners such as Panasonic and LG, it plans to produce its own batteries alongside them. By 2030, the business forecasts battery production requirements to be around 3 terawatt hours, based on a 40-50% annual growth rate. If we use the same unit as the 2022 prediction, that is 300 gigawatt hours. To put that in terms you're probably familiar with in day-to-day electric motoring, that's 3 billion kilowatt hours. I hope you understand what I'm trying to say. It's great that it makes the majority of its batteries in-house. But which house? According to rumors, the Project Bobcat could be a part of this transition to more controlled production line. This appears to be the most likely scenario, although Tesla CEO Elon Musk has other intentions for the area. The Austin, Texas location, according to Musk, would be a natural utopia. In a region near the Colorado River, there is a public park free to visitors. He even envisions a riverfront promenade with hiking and cycling pathways, as well as birds, butterflies, and fish in the stream. Along with the obvious environmental benefit of being open to the public, being open to the public will surely boost local residents' mental health. And it might even draw visitors, particularly those who are admirers of the company and its CEO. This would be akin to Apple Park or Googleplex, as well as Chinese manufacturer NIO's recent foray into the realm of eco-parks with its NIO Park. A land tract of 16,950 acres containing function rooms, living spaces, and green spaces. While we don't know what Project Bobcat's true aims are, we do know that Tesla is planning some major changes in the near future. In less than 10 years, we see that the company is strengthening its eco achievements, and there will also be substantial breakthroughs in the world of batteries, as well as a greater choice of models available, including the much-anticipated, inexpensive sub-$25,000 model. Moreover, the Bobcat project will serve as a satellite to the main Gigafactory, which Musk expects to be operational by the end of 2021. Tesla now has around 300 job openings on its website, but by the end of 2022, the company aims to employ 10,000 workers at the factory. That's after initially projecting a workforce of only 5,000 people. The Tesla bot is an example of Musk's showmanship, in which he reveals that Tesla is working on interesting products that will be released years in the future in order to energize backers such as employees, customers, and innovators. Those announcements frequently do not occur on the expected schedule. We are all familiar with Tesla's other ongoing projects. It is not the only thing Tesla is considering right now. Delaying in Cybertruck production as well as SN20 going into orbit, Tesla has a lot to sort out. It has recently announced its humanoid robot concept with the name TeslaBot. Elon Musk recently tweeted about it. We are also good at sensors and batteries, and will probably have a prototype next year that looks like this. Musk said soon after an actor in a bodysuit designed to look like the Tesla robot appeared wildly on stage. He remarked that the actor was not a real robot, but the TeslaBot will be real. For sure, it will be as Tesla, regardless of the delays, is still the best-known company and couldn't be outrun. Many people admire Elon Musk because of his discoveries and researches. A fan account commented on Elon's recent reveal of SpaceX's telescope. If you haven't watched that video, I recommend you watch it. Normally, I'd say we'll never get to Mars and build a base. Hell, we won't even build one on our moon. But Elon Musk is the only one capable of making me think that not only is it possible, based on everything he's accomplished so far, but inevitable. All the governments with all their current space programs combined can't move me in the way Elon's drive and vision for the future have. And it truly boggles my mind how much I admire this man. Elon Musk might be the Thomas Edison of the 21st century. His ideas have earned him numerous Entrepreneur and Innovator of the Year accolades, and they are a frequent topic of conversation among business leaders and consumers. While some of the businesses Musk has started are more well-known than others, he has been actively innovating since he was a child. Let's hear a short story. When Musk was a child, he liked video games before he popularized electronic automobiles and began thinking about colonization of Mars. As a result, when he was 12 years old, he created his own. That's impressive enough, but Musk, being Musk, decided to sell the game for $500 to a magazine. The game name was Blastar. It is still present on the web. If you're curious to find out where Elon started, there it is. So, what is your take on this matter? Will Tesla soon tell us about the big project, or do we have to wait until the rest of the projects get settled? Tell us in the comments. If you want to see our upcoming videos, subscribe to the channel, ring the bell icon, and don't forget to like the video as well. That's all from my side. Thanks for watching.